The emotion from Jarryd Hayne's rape trial has boiled over outside Newcastle Court. While the disgraced footballer was led to jail, his supporters refused to accept his sentence, abusing and spitting at the woman he sexually assaulted. Tonight is the first night Hayne will spend behind bars, where he will remain until at least 2025.
Jarryd Hayne's denial, illustrated by his family and friends.
Where's the lady?
At the centre of these deplorable scenes, his pregnant wife, Amelia.
Let her get in the car!
Some of these men stared down the convicted rapist victim. She walked from court, one even spitting in her direction.
You touch me again!
The camera's on you.
You touch me again!
She should hold herself, her head up high. A very inspiring young woman.
Earlier, they'd formed a scrum around Jarryd Hayne.
Jarryd, are you concerned you're going to jail today?
A front row of supporters.
Put it in my face. Don't touch him.
As the disgraced NRL star took his final steps as a free man. At least the next 3 years and 8 months of Jarryd Hayne's life will be spent behind bars. One of the great players, now a prisoner. It was league grand final night in 2018 when the dual Dally M winner sexually assaulted a 26-year-old woman. Catching a taxi to her Newcastle home, he kept the meter running and, after leaving her physically injured, travelled back to Sydney. Two trials later, Hayne was found guilty, and today his victim gave him a piece of her mind. In front of Hayne and his dozens of supporters, the woman described wanting to end her life. I have spent countless hours crying. The feeling of violation and feeling dirty doesn't go away. I have nightmares and flashbacks of his face looking right through me. It was when someone suggested she could help other victims that she found strength to fight. What I experienced was horrible. Nobody should ever have to feel that way. I am destroyed and damaged, but I am still standing.
And I hope other women can draw inspiration from her, and men can draw inspiration from her or whoever, and have the confidence to come to the police.
In a shock move, Jarryd Hayne also took to the stand, again declaring he didn't do it, and to blame media coverage of the case for ruining his NRL comeback. He revealed he was about to sign a one-year, $500,000 contract with St George Illawarra on the same day he was arrested.
Best friend and former Eels teammate Tim Manor gave a reference for Hayne, saying he was known as a part-time Christian until he went to Bible College in 2019. That transformation and his charitable work, noted by the judge, also struggled to understand Hayne's continued denial. He'll have until 2025 to be enlightened. Tiffany Genders, Nine News.